Hey guys, have you ever looked at an image that mesmerized you completely? Was it by a famous photographer? How was he able to capture the real essence and beauty of his subject? And more importantly, can you do the same? These are some of the questions you might come across after looking at great portrait photography. But did you know you could excel at the art yourself with just a little practice and the right Canon lens? There are a number of options on the market, which makes it difficult to choose the best one. In this video, we compiled a list of the top 5 best portrait lenses for Canon on the market today. Be sure to watch till the end for our best recommendation. If you want more information or updated pricing on the products mentioned here, check out the links in the description below. If you have another product you'd like us to review, let us know by leaving a comment down below. Without further ado, let's get started. First, we have Best Canon 50mm Portrait Lens, Canon EF 50mm f2.5 Compact Macro Lens. The most notable feature of this Canon lens is its floating optical system. This might sound strange because not many come with this great addition. The optical system enables you to get sharp delineation on your images at all focusing distances. This, when coupled with the maximum aperture size, helps to capture images in low light settings. Its pros are, it allows for less distortion. Its better lens construction makes for higher durability. Its filter size is good for cleaner and brighter photography. It allows for a wide diagonal angle of view, which is 46 degrees. And its front group of the linear extension comes with a system with AFD. However, it does not come with a zoom lens. It's less portable due to larger dimensions, and there's less warranty as compared to other models. Bottom line is, it's the best Canon 50mm portrait lens. Its wide aperture allows you a better bokeh, and its focal length is only 50mm, which allows for better close-ups. Next, we have Best Canon Lens for Landscape and Portrait, Canon EF 70-200mm f4L USM Telephoto Zoom Lens. Since the lens comes with a zoom feature, a range of people can use it easily. The camera lens allows for a focal length between 70 and 200. This means that people wanting to capture indoor as well as outdoor photography can benefit from it. Its pros are, its wide range of diagonal view is allowed. Its lens construction is smooth and steady. Its front lens does not rotate at all during focusing. It allows for focus adjustment with a special USM system, and allows photographers to capture close-ups despite standing some feet away. However, it's heavier than most other models. It's not suitable for indoor photography, and the tripod collar needs to be bought separately. Bottom line is, it's the best Canon lens for landscape and portrait. Its greater focal length allows for greater magnification, and its higher aperture lens allows capturing a shallow depth of field. Next, we have best for the money, Canon EF 50mm f1.8 STM lens. When it comes to consumers and recent buyers, the weight of this product means a great deal. Fans of the product love the compact shape and stature of the lens that allows them to carry it effortlessly. It also comes with an advanced USM system that ensures complete silence. This not only allows photographers to stay focused, but also ensures better imagery. Its pros are, its movie servo design allows for better stills. Its better construction adds to higher durability. It allows horizontal, diagonal, and vertical views. It's great for action, portrait, and nighttime photography. And its complete silence is ensured via the stepping motor system. However, it only allows a maximum magnification of 0.21x. It has more distortion compared to 35mm focal length. And it creates a larger in-focus area, thus hindering the sharpness of the single subject. Bottom line is, it's the best for the money. Its maximum aperture size is f1.8, which allows greater subject focus. And it comes with a 50mm focal length that is ideal for indoor photography. Next, we have runner-up, Canon EF 100mm f2.8L IS USM Macro Lens. The product stands out to us because of its high-quality design and construction. It is engineered with the most high-quality materials and has been carefully weather-selected to ensure robust results at all times. Its pros are, the inner focusing system comes with USM. Its higher diagonal view lets you take great pictures. It allows crystal clear detailing in portrait photography. It allows full-time manual focusing, thus aiding creativity. And it also includes image stabilization, which is extremely sophisticated. However, you cannot use extenders with it. Its close-up magnification is set up at only 1x, and it does not have any compatible close-up lenses. The bottom line is, its maximum aperture is set at f2.8. It comes with a 100mm large focal length. Its supreme lens construction makes it last long. Finally, we have, best overall, Canon EF 135mm F2L USM lens. It stands out to us because of the beautiful blur it creates. The 135mm focal length allows for capturing the sharp image of your subject and creating a perfect natural blur in the background. Moreover, it ensures light and soft bokeh necessary for a more aesthetic picture quality. Its pros are, it allows for fast autofocus, its soft bokeh is ensured via the circular bokeh. It doesn't create noise, hence allows you to focus better. Its large aperture length allows for a close focusing distance, and it comes with an ultra-soft lens case hood and a smooth case. However, the warranty is less, the lens is not zoomable, and the price is relatively higher than other models. The bottom line is, it's the best Canon lens for portraits. It comes with a micro ultrasonic motor design, and its dispersion glass is ultra low and contains fluorite elements. There you have it, our top 5 best portrait lenses for Canon on the market. Check out the links in the description below for detailed information and latest pricing. If you thought this video was helpful, please smash that like button and consider subscribing. If you didn't, let me know why in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.